In June of 1971, three Russian cosmonauts would make history when they docked to Salyut 1, the world's first orbiting space station. After 23 days of scientific experiments, many regarding the human body's reaction to prolonged weightlessness, they undocked from the station and prepared to re-enter the Earth's atmosphere. However, unknown to the crew, on that day they would make history for another, much darker reason. Due to faulty design and oversight from Soviet engineers, the cabin of Soyuz 11 would depressurize 100 miles over the Earth's surface, exposing the three to the vacuum of space and asphyxiating them in under a minute. In this video, I will explain how and why it happened, along with what happens to the human body when exposed to the essentially perfect vacuum of space. When Neil Armstrong took his historic one small step, it effectively spelled the end of the space race. Mounting failures with the Soviet N-1 moon rocket led the Soviet Union to abandon their goal of landing man on the moon in 1970. In shifting focus to orbiting space stations, they would find more success. The Salyut program would begin with a launch on April 19th of 1971 and would continue with the launches of seven more space stations, with the same basic design used for the Russian core module of the International Space Station. 2 days before the launch of Soyuz 11, physicians detected what they believed to be tuberculosis in the flight engineer, Valery Kubasov. According to Soviet mission regulations, the entire primary crew was cut from the flight, with the backup crew taking their place. This secondary crew consisted of Georgi Dobrovolsky, Viktor Patsayev, and Vladimir Volkov. Soyuz 11, also known by its call sign Yantar, launched June 6th from Baikonur Cosmodrome and successfully docked with Salyut 1 a day later. The crew spent the better part of a month performing science experiments, conducting live television broadcasts, exercising, and otherwise observing the effects of long-term microgravity on their bodies. The crew also accomplished another first, with Patsayev celebrating his 38th birthday, the crew treating him to a surprise of veal, cookies, and blackberry juice. On the 29th of June 1971, with the objectives of the flight complete, the crew loaded their scientific experiments back into the Soyuz and undocked from the station. 3 hours later, they fired their engine to initiate their descent back into Earth's atmosphere. The crew communicated with ground control, Volkov asking them to make sure a bottle of cognac was ready for them upon landing. 29 minutes before touchdown, explosive charges separated the descent module from the orbital and service modules, exposing the shield that would protect the cosmonauts from the heat of re-entry. Spacecraft descending through the atmosphere travel at supersonic speeds, and the friction between the craft and the surrounding air creates a sheath of plasma leading to a communications blackout that can last up to 10 minutes. However, contact with the crew was lost well before this. Unknown to ground control, all three crew members had perished 40 seconds after descent module separation. In 1965, a test of a pressurized suit in a vacuum chamber at Johnson Space Center would end in near disaster when a leak exposed Jim LeBlanc to near vacuum. LeBlanc lost consciousness 14 seconds and awoke after 30 seconds, having suffered no long-term effects. When questioned later, he remarked that his last memory was the sensation of the saliva bubbling on his tongue. Exposure to the vacuum of space has several different effects on the human body. The first and most obvious is the lack of oxygen, leading to suffocation. This is the primary cause of death, as useful consciousness is lost in around 15 seconds. The boiling point of bodily fluids is reduced to below regular body temperature, and saliva on the tongue would boil. Contrary to common sense, it would most likely feel cold, not hot, as the water naturally cools as it expands. Gases dissolved in the bloodstream would come out of solution and try to escape through the skin, leading to intense swelling of the body and fatal blood clots. The reflex reaction to hold your breath would counterintuitively expand the air in your lungs, causing them to rupture. Death by exposure to a vacuum is nowhere near a painless experience, but mercifully for the cosmonauts, it was swift. Before we get into the actual cause of the catastrophe, I'll take this moment to remind you to like the video if you're enjoying it and to consider subscribing. It really helps the channel out with the algorithm and allows my content to be reached by a wider audience. Now, back to the video. The actual cause of the depressurization event was traced back to a breathing ventilation valve, which was located between the descent and orbital modules. When the two separated, the explosive bolts holding the modules together fired simultaneously when they should have fired sequentially. The force of this simultaneous firing jolted loose the seal on the pressure equalization valve, causing it to open. Ideally, the valve would close automatically, but due to poor design, it didn't. Alexei Leonov, who was on the original flight team and who was replaced by the backup crew, knew the hardware well, having spent extensive amounts of time in the simulator. He advised the crew to close this faulty valve manually instead of relying on the hardware to function as intended. The positions of the bodies in the capsule, along with flight recorder data, told a grim story. Directly after module separation, the cosmonauts could hear the hissing sound of air escaping the capsule. Still strapped into their seats, they frantically turned off buzzing communications equipment and ventilators to isolate where the sound was coming from. Realizing that the noise was coming from under Dobrovolsky's seat, the cosmonauts unbuckled to try anything they could do to plug the leak. Unfortunately, it was futile. Even if they knew where the leak was immediately, there was no way to fix it in time. Alexei Leonov had practiced manually closing this valve and found that it took him almost an entire minute to do so. After around 14 seconds of sheer panic, oxygen-starved blood would start to make its way into the brain and hypoxemia would set in. The only thing that could have saved them were pressurized suits, but in a twist of tragic irony, the capsule was not big enough for the three of them to wear them. This, along with the design flaw that actually caused the depressurization, are just two in a long list of problems that took the toll of human life in the early years of space exploration. If you've watched this far, I'd again like to thank you. I do enjoy making these videos, but even for how simplistic the editing is, they are quite time-consuming to make. Your engagement really means a lot to me, as I spend quite a bit of my free time doing the research, recording the voiceover, and putting it all together. Hearing from all of you has really made it worth it, so thank you.